by 15-2. The State of Israel shall, in accordance with its obligations under the Convention on the Prevention and Punishment of the Crime of Genocide, in relation to the Palestinians in Gaza, take all measures within its power to prevent the commission of all acts within the scope of Article 2 of the Convention, in particular, A, killing members of the group, B, causing serious bodily or mental harm to members of the group, C, deliberately inflicting on the group conditions of life calculated to bring about its physical destruction in whole or in part, and D, imposing measures intended to prevent births within the group.
South Africa has accused Israel of breaching the 1948 UN Genocide Convention set up in the aftermath of the World War II and the Holocaust during its military campaign in Gaza sparked by the October 7 attacks by Hamas. The court did not pass judgment on whether or not Israel is actually committing genocide, but handed down emergency orders while it considers the wider accusation, a process that is likely to take years. President Cyril Ramaphosa and the ruling council of the ruling African National Congress Party erupted in cheers, singing and dancing after judges read the order.
But I am satisfied with the directives that have been given. I believe that in exercising the order, there would have to be a ceasefire.
The case and their government's involvement in it has also generated public interest in South Africa, where many have sympathy for the Palestinian quest for statehood. In Cape Town and Pretoria, people gathered to watch the ruling, which was carried in full on state television. As the ICJ judge announced the provisional measures, applause erupted among a diverse crowd of about 30 gathered in a community center in Cape Town, some wearing earrings and colors in support of Palestine. The ICJ's rulings are binding on all parties, but it has no mechanism to enforce them. Sometimes they are completely ignored. Pretoria has long been a vocal supporter of the Palestinian cause, with the ANC party often linking it to its own struggle against apartheid. The October 7th Hamas attack resulted in the death of around 1,140 people in Israel, most of them civilians, according to an AFP tally based on official Israel figures. At least 26,000 Palestinians have been killed in the Gaza Strip in the Israeli bombardments and ground offensive. In Uganda, Justice Julia Sebutinde, a Ugandan citizen judge and first African woman to sit on the International Court of Justice, voted against all the provisional measures the court had ordered Israel to undertake following the case brought by South Africa on the war in Gaza. Justice Sebutinde was the sole judge among the 17 on the court who ruled against every one of the emergency orders against Israel, even when the Israeli judge accepted some of them. Social media has not been kind to the Ugandan, with some saying Uganda should be ashamed of her position on the war. But some have come to Sebutinde's defense, pointing out that Israel alone cannot be held accountable for the destruction of Gaza. The battleground is drawn between the Israel Defense Forces and Hamas, which is equally causing chaos and even started it. Uganda, which is the current chair of the Non-Aligned Movement, maintains the same position as other member states. NAM on Saturday, January 20th, called Israel's military campaign in the Gaza Strip illegal and strongly condemned indiscriminate attacks against Palestinian civilians, civilian infrastructure, and the forced displacement of the Palestinian population.